Hello, my name is Mr. Thorne and welcome back to Mr. Thorne Does Phonics. Don't forget to like up the video and subscribe to my channel to find out more. In today's lesson, we're going to learn about the OR sound made with the OR digraph. And here it is to my side. OR, code for the OR sound. OR, OR, OR. Some people might pronounce it like this. OR, OR, OR. And that depends where in the world you are from. I use the OR sound and here it is blended in words. F, OR, K. Fork. Th, or n, thorn. Sh, or t, short. K, or n, corn. Here are some more. Marvellous, marvellous blending. What a brilliant effort. You're really, really good at that. I can tell you've been practicing. Now the OR sound is in other words made by different spelling patterns like the AU spelling pattern in autumn, or the AUGH in court, or the OUR in pour, like when you pour a drink, or the OOR in door. So there are lots and lots of different spelling patterns that feature the OR sound, but today's video is all about the OR sound with the OR digraph. Now, I wonder if Geraldine is going to be able to determine which words feature that OR sound with the OR spelling pattern. I hope she can do it. I hope she's been flexing her giraffe muscles. Can she do it?
Geraldine, you phoneme queen, back out on the phonics scene. Giraffing here, giraffing there, all over London with phoneme flair. Always willing to have a go, how many phonemes do you know? Looking for a letter sound, show us the objects you have found.
Hi Geraldine.
Meh.
Welcome back. Today Geraldine, we're going to learn all about the OR sound, coded with the OR digraph. Can you see that? Good girl. It's the OR sound. OR, OR, OR. Can you have a go at making that sound?
Bore, bore, bore.
No, not bore. OR, OR. Have a go then.
OR.
Good girl, well done Geraldine. Now the OR digraph is often code for other sounds in English, but in this video, in this episode, we're just looking at the OR sound. So, anything around the house, Geraldine, that features that OR sound?
Bore.
No, not bore, Geraldine.
Meh.
It's ever so rude, Geraldine, that you keep saying it's boring.
Meh.
Now, Geraldine, go and find some objects around the house that feature the OR sound. Ooh, Geraldine, this is a good piece of equipment you found. This is a useful tool. And this is a fork. And fork has got the OR sound in the middle. Good girl, well done. Is that what you use when you're eating your leaves, Geraldine? No, you just use your mouth, don't you? Straight off the tree. Good girl, Geraldine. Okay, so you found a fork, Geraldine. No, no throwy. Thank you. No, Geraldine, no throw. No throw. Oh, Geraldine, what are these? Goodness me, you're going to have to show them to me properly so I can see them. Are these... Turn them around, Geraldine. Are these a pair of swimming shorts? Ah, of course, shorts have got the... Geraldine, don't throw things about around, please. Geraldine, those were shorts. Those are my shorts. Have them back. No, no, Geraldine. Shorts has got the OR sound in the middle. Good girl. And Geraldine.
Meh.
Okay, anything else can you find? Ooh, Geraldine. This is my passport. Look after it. You must never mess around with a passport. Geraldine.
Meh.
Don't throw my passport, thank you very much. Look after it.
Now, Geraldine, passport has got the or sound. Well done. Anything else? Ooh, Geraldine, look what you found. It is a corkscrew. Aha! For unplugging all those bottles of wine that Mr. Thorne drank. I thought so. And corkscrew has got the or sound near the beginning, coded by the OR digraph. Well done, Geraldine. Anything else? Oh, Geraldine, are you advertising again? You are, aren't you? But for a good reason. You found your story. Your storybook. And story has got the OR digraph, code for the OR sound. And here is your story. Well done, Geraldine. Available where from, Geraldine?
Meh, meh, meh.
Where can you get this book, Geraldine?
Meh.
Is that Amazon, did you just say? Yes, I thought so. Good girl, Geraldine. Okay, Geraldine, you found lots of objects today. Have one last go of that... Have one last go of that or sound. No, that's your storybook, Geraldine. Or.
Meh, meh, meh.
No, Geraldine. Or.
Or.
See you next time.
Meh.
Geraldine has done it, hasn't she? She's done it. Even though she's a little bit cheeky and a little bit naughty, she still managed to find those objects around the house that feature the or sound. Clever, clever girl. What will she do next? Now it's your turn to have a look around the house or around the classroom. Or whilst you're out and about shopping or walking down the street, what other words can you find that feature the or sound with the OR digraph? Have a good look, good luck, like at the video, subscribe, add a comment underneath, follow on Instagram or Twitter at Mr. Thorne, and I will see you down the road. Bye for now.